Hi, people of the Philippines and people of the world. Hit the button below. And you will be subscribing to the Boy Abunda Talk channel on YouTube. Let's keep talking.
Infinite Monkeys and the Boy Abunda Talk channel in partnership with Lani Abunda Amasa, Thor B. Santos, Michael Alan Sikat, Boy Abunda, and Boy So present.
Legalization of marijuana.
Same by marriage.
Yes or no.
Divorce.
Yes or no.
Mahalaga ba ang pagsali sa debate? Isang kandidato sa Senate or Senado pa?
Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. Welcome to Fast Talk Plus and Why with our 2022 senatorial candidates. Ang ating panauhin po, Teddy Baguilat. Teddy, maraming salamat.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, boy.
Kumusta ang buhay kampanya?
Well, kasi first time kong tumakbo sa national. I've been in politics for 30 years. It's all local. So, ibang-iba talaga sa national kasi iba-ibang mga uri, mga iba-ibang mga orientasyon yung nakikita mo, nami-meet mo araw-araw. And I might say, itong kampanyang ito kakaiba kasi yung mga kabataan, talagang involved sila. Because sa amin sa Ifugao, ang very active sa politika, yung mga kababaihan, mga barangay leaders, saka yung mga seniors. It's rare that you see the young being in the rallies, no, engaging you in questions and answers, no. Pero dito sa kampanyang ito, makikita mo talaga yung mga kabataan and some other sectors na kadalasan hindi lumalabas sa politika, no, like yung mga katutubo, LGBTQ community and the professionals. So for me, maybe it's because of the group that I'm with, yun yung kanilang base talaga, but talagang nagugulat ako sa mga first-time voters, maybe 70% ng mga rallies namin, mga first-time voters. Kaya kung pagod ka, parang yun yung nagbibigay ng sigla at inspiration to go on with the campaign. Yeah.
So you like engaging with the young?
Yeah, yeah.
Ano ang madalas na itinatanong sa'yo? Anong madalas na pinag-uusapan ninyo ng mga kabataan?
Programs. They really ask about your programs for the environment, education. Even me as an indigenous person, marami sila kanila curious, no? Ano ba ang katutubo, ano ba yung kultura nila, ano ba yung ipinagalaban nila? Because I always talk about indigenous people's rights, about the environment. So they ask questions related to the programs that I present. So kakaiba yon. Because normally pag election sa amin, ang tinatanong naman nila, kailan nyo papagawa yung aming barangay hall, yung scholarship namin kulang, yung kalsada namin, kailan nyo papasemento. Nobody really asks about, no? Ano ba yung mga bills na itutulak mo, anti-discrimination law, freedom of information or environment. Pero yung mga bata, tinatanong nila yun eh.
At natutuwa ako dahil ngayon ko lamang nalaman na sa Ifugao, aktibo ang mga kababaihan at ang mga seniors. At ang kanilang mga katanungan ay iba as opposed to the questions of the young people that you are now engaging.
Yeah. Mostly kasi pag women, livelihood. Ganon din ng senior citizens. Tanda na kami, na gusto namin sana matisman lang, matikman na makasakay sa sasakyan. So ayusin natin yung kalsada. Mm-hmm. O kaya barangay hall para meron kaming pagtitipunan ng mga women and seniors. So those are their concerns, no? Mostly gut issues rin, no? Talagang kabuhayan. But with the people that we're meeting in our rallies, they still talk about gut issues. So syempre, pag mag-speech ka naman, kabuhayan, paano mo lalaban ang pandemya. But when you go in depth and kinakausap mo sila sa mga fora, kaya after the rallies, they asked about indigenous people's rights, right, about the environment. Yeah.
You're up against 63 other senatorial candidates. Sabi mo nga, this is your first national elections. Pero kahit papano, you've been in politics for 30 years and may tinatawag tayong gut feel. What are your chances?
I know, wala akong pantasya na favorite ako, no? Because maraming hindi nakakakilala sa akin. And the Senate is really about popularity. It's a popularity contest, no? Plain and simple. So yun yung kulang namin. It's really the awareness. But one is we have the base. In my case, that's the youth, that's the Lenny base, Lenny Kiko base. And then I'm also from Northern Luzon. So hindi natin makapagkakaila ng mga Pilipino, very religionalistic. So Ilocano ako, Cordillera and Igorot. So that's also my base. And then hopefully I can get the indigenous people's vote. Kasi kung tutuusin, there are around, they say around 10% of the population are indigenous peoples, no? So yun yung hamon sa akin, how to get them out. Kasi kadalasan nga they don't participate in the elections. Marami sa kanila hindi pa nga registered. Pero now I'm been meeting with the indigenous peoples from Luzon down to Mindanao. So hopefully, aside from the Leni base, Northern Luzon, Ilocano vote, then you have also the indigenous peoples.
What sets you apart?
Well, one is my experience. No? Because tulad ng sabi ko, popularity contest. But the Senate is really about naiintindihan mo ba yung problema ng mga taong bayan. I've been a mayor and governor. And boy, pag mayor ka at saka governor ka, araw-araw ang kausap mo, tao, problema nila. So I'm used to solving problems. No? When I was governor, naalis namin yung Ifugao sa list of 10 poorest provinces in the Philippines. So that's one. Second, it's your experience as a legislator. Again, kinakailangan sabihan natin yung mga taong bayan na ang trabaho ng senador ay magpasa ng batas. More than anything else, no, you pass laws. And madaming mga reklamo, mga batas na ipasa, pero grabe naman ang epekto sa buhay ng mga tao. So yung aking experience na when I was a congressman for 9 years, bago ako magtulak ng batas, kinakausap ko talaga yung mga sectors na mamaapektuhan ng batas. So if it's about agriculture, dapat konsultahin mo muna yung farmers. No? So that's my skill as an indigenous person. And third is, I'm an IP. Maybe it's high time na makakuha rin tayo ng lente ng isang katutubo na consensus builder. Ganun kasi ang demokrasya ng IP. Eh, no? We may disagree, but at the end of the day, dapat collective decision maybe. So maybe that's something that I can bring into the Senate.
Maraming salamat, Teddy. Ngayon, umpisa naman natin ang ating fast talk. Our political fast talk. Legalization of marijuana, payag ka ba o hindi at bakit?
Produkto namin sa Cordillera. Right now, I'm for medical marijuana. Marami naman talaga nangangailangan ng yung sa rehabilitative purpose, saka yung pag-away ng yung sakit, no, yung pain. And marijuana is it, no? Ang problem ko kasi is yung implementation and enforcement. That's why start first with medical marijuana, tapos kung maganda naman yung implementation, hindi na aabuso, then maybe we can, I'm open to discussing recreational marijuana. Yeah.
Same-sex marriage. Yes, no, why?
Same-sex civil union is easier to defend. I'm for a same-sex marriage. Kinakailangan naman na mabigyan ng pagkakataon yung LGBTQ community to experience married life, no? But yun nga, lagi kong sinasabi sa kanila, unahin muna natin yung anti-discrimination law, yung sexual orientation, gender identity and expression equality law. And then after that, let's move on to same-sex. Sabi ko nga, civil union, mas madali. Kasi pag marriage, nababahiran ng religious distinction. Yun yung ayaw natin. Gusto natin iwasan yun. So same-sex civil union, I'm for it.
Nuclear energy, yes or no, why?
I'm for cleaner and safer energy. So kung prioritization, mas gusto ko ang renewable energy. Right now, I'm not for nuclear energy because may toxic waste rin siya. And then sa Pilipinas, yung ating geographical situation na we're in the ring of fire, maraming lindol, so nuclear power plants may not be safe for the Philippines.
Department of OFW, yes, no, why?
Yes, no, ang dami nating mga ahensya na mga pamahalaan na tumutugon sa pangangailangan ng mga overseas Filipinos. Minsan nalilito sila. Sino ba yung tutugon sa problema namin doon sa bansa kung saan kami? So kung maganda kung may Department of Overseas Filipinos. Besides, yung mandato niya, mas malaki kasi departamento siya. So I'm for a Department of OFWs.
Divorce. Yes, no, bakit?
Semantics palitan. Same, dissolution of civil union. Divorce, again, brings in a religious discussion, no? But essentially, I'm for divorce, but pag tinutulak namin yung batas, because I'm a principal author of the divorce law, binansagan namin na dissolution of civil union with conditions.
Federalism or unitary presidential form of government, why?
Right now kasi parang ambivalent ako doon. I'm more for a parliamentary form of government. Mm-hmm. Because parliamentary, talagang political parties, malino yung pinag-alaban nila. And that could be either in a unitary form of government or a federal form of government. So mas doon ako kumikiling.
Allow POGO operations to continue in the country, yes or no, and why?
Yes, as long as it's really regulated. And then, kasi may mga scandals that go with it. So talagang bantayan yung operations para hindi siya maging sistema for human trafficking. So okay naman ako sa POGO.
Election surveys condition people's minds. Yes or no, why?
It does in a way, although for politicians kasi the ultimate survey is the election itself. Eh. So sa akin, while it's a guide, it's still a trend na hindi naman siya yung tapos na kung ito na yung kalabasan ng survey.
Are you in favor of charter change? Yes or no, at bakit?
So ngayon hindi. Because kadalasan pag pinag-uusapan ng charter change, hindi naman about the economy, hindi naman about political reform. Eh. It's usually about extension of terms. Naranasan ko yan. Eh. We talk about federalism, kaya kinakailangan ng charter change. Pero ang pinupush talaga, ang binubulong is extension of terms, no term limits. So sa akin, sa ngayon with the political climate, I'm not for charter change.
Anti-terrorism law needs to be amended. Agree or disagree? Why?
Ako, it needs to be repealed. No? Because there are already a lot of laws that will help us fight terrorism. Ang masama dito sa anti-terrorism law is yung pwede ka na lang huliin without a warrant of arrest. Tapos yung magtatalaga sa'yo as a terrorist, this anti-terrorism council, napaka-arbitrary yung kanilang decision na anybody who is a critic can be tagged as a terrorist.
Teddy, bilang senador, susuportahan mo ba ang isang bill na nag-aamyenda sa batas na nagbabawal ng substitution by withdrawal ng mga kandidato sa eleksyon? Oo, hindi, bakit?
Yes. Ang grounds lang naman talaga for substitution sa akin is kung namatay yung kandidato, kaya nagkasakit na hindi na siya makakapagkampanya. That has always been what we follow as politicians. So normally, when you file, nakadesisyon ka na. So bakit pa kinakailangan meron pang time na magbago ka ng isip mo through substitution. So I support that proposed bill kung meron man.
Mahalaga ba ang pagsali sa debate ng isang kandidato sa eleksyon? Oo, hindi, bakit?
Yes, because yun yung pagkakataon mo na ilahad yung iyong plataforma. Eh. The way we attend these interviews, these types of fora, no? Kasi kadalasan kasi pagkampanya, you just talk about, no, what's popular among the people, but the hard questions are asked during the debates. And pag ikaw ay leader, crisis leader ka eh. Mm-hmm. No? So yun dapat sana yung payagan for all candidates na makilahok sila sa debate. And it's their opportunity to present their platform. At the same time, yung mga hard questions na tatanong sa kanila.
What is wrong with our educational system and why?
Kulang sa budget. It's still the highest in terms of allocation in my experience, but it's still not enough. No? And then secondly, there's a need to retool the educational system to talk more about yung labanan yung historical revisionism, that's one. To talk more about human rights education, to talk more about environmental education. Pati nga mga katutubo, minsan mali yung pagka-portray sa ating textbooks. Eh. So sa akin talaga, kinakailangan magkaroon siguro ng malalim na pag-aaral. What's wrong with our educational system? At tugunan yun.
Philippine political polarization is predatory, almost cannibalistic. Agree or disagree?
Yeah.
Why?
Agree. Ako nga eh. Dahil LP ako, dilaw ka agad, ganyan. Pag dilaw ka, ganito ka. No? Pag ikaw naman ay makabayan like sila Neri, pula ka, terorista ka, mga ganon. Pag manalo ka, ang kikilingan mo lang ay yung partido. That's something that ako, ever since I was a politician, after the elections, tama na yung politika. No? You're now the governor, you're now the mayor. You're the president of the entire province. So yun yung aking pananaw. But politics these days, napakahirap kasi binansagan ka na doon, tapos ikaw kami naman dito. And that's why maganda rin yung isang katutubo kasi consensus building.
Will you support a bill banning candidates facing charges from running in the elections? Yes or no? Why?
Sa akin, if they're convicted. Kasi marami naman talaga trumped up charges. I've been a victim of that. And there are courts naman that decide with finality, whether it's Sandigan Bayan, the Supreme Court. So sa akin, if they're convicted, then they should not be allowed to run or file their candidacies.
Party list system, Is this an effective means to prevent traditional elitist politics? Yes or no, and why?
It should be, but the way it's structured now, it isn't. May mga party list tayo na ang talaga mga kumakatawan naman na supposedly sa mga batayang sektor, hindi naman galing dun sa sektor na yon, no? But sayang eh. So that's why I think there's a need to amend the party list law. No?
Cheating, pandaraya happens during elections. Yes or no? Why?
Yeah, it happens at the sink level. It happens at the canvassing. No? It happens during the campaign. There's a lot of vote buying these days, so hindi malaya yung botante na pumili kasi nababayaran sila. I think that's the most important thing when we talk about electoral reforms, is how to prevent cheating during the elections. Kasi ang corruption naman begins during the campaign. You spend so much, no, millions and millions of pesos just to be elected as mayor. Pag nanalo ka, saan mo babawiin yon? So that's why we have to think of political economic reforms, no? Especially focusing on how elections are being run.
Senate investigations are a waste of public funds. Agree or disagree, and why?
Hindi naman. Basta may patutunguhan. Because Senate investigations actually, even sa Congress, sa House of Representatives, ang tawag doon ay congressional inquiries in aid of legislation. So it's supposed to lead to an amendment of a law or perhaps a policy change. So kung puro investiga na lang, para magka-pogi points and then wala naman nangyayari, then that's a waste of money. But if ang intent mo really is to craft amendments to the law or a new law, then these investigations do help.
Allow or disallow Philippine-China joint exploration in the West Philippine Sea, and why?
I'm open to that. But I'd rather open it up to other players. To get the best possible arrangement. So whether it's China or South Korea or United States or Europe, open ako doon. No? But first of all, we should be the main player. This is ours. So kung papasok ka dito, joint exploration, pero tayo yung main player, Pilipinas.
Teddy, pag ikay pinalad at naging senador ng Pilipinas at naroon ka na, would you want to be Senate President? Yes or no, and why?
Hindi pa ako nakarating sa ganong level, because pag Senate President ka, it really takes craftsmanship, no, and statesmanship to be able to perform your role as a Senate President. I'd rather be just a good senator muna for the moment if I win.
What for you would be a practical solution to reduce the traffic problem, and why?
Public transport is really the key. No? We have so many private vehicles in our streets. And then let's also build better pedestrian lanes and bike lanes. Now, because in other countries I've been to, talagang kalahati ng tao naglalakad, nagbibisikleta. Yung iba naman, okay, public transport. Bihira yung private vehicles. But in the Philippines, hindi. Mahilig tayo talaga sa kotse. So sa akin, that's the key. Public transport, better pedestrian and bike lanes.
Family scandal. Niloko ba talaga ang sambayan ng Pilipino? Oo, hindi, at bakit?
Oo naman. I mean, the PPEs, no, were overpriced, no, yung sa bidding process, no, because I've been a mayor and governor, no, I know the procurement process, no. Bago magkaroon ng procurement process, the bidders should be qualified, should be pre-qualified. Pero yung mga nangyari is, wala naman silang kakayahan to deliver such a big volume of supplies, pero sila pa rin yung nanalo. So, talagang niloko tayo.
Pwede pa bang bumaba ang buwis ng mga empleyado? Oo, hindi, at bakit?
Sa akin, pwede naman pagbaguhin natin yung taxation system, gawin natin more progressive. Ibig sabihin, yung mga talagang maliit lang yung sweldo, wag naman masyadong malaki yung kanilang buwis. Yung mga mayayaman, mas malaki sana yung ma-contribute nila sa budget ng pamahalaan. Because ang tao naman, magbabayad naman yan ng buwis. Eh. Basta alam nila na napupunta yung kanilang buwis sa tamang paraan, no, sa programa ng mga government.
Papapasukin mo ba sa bahay mo ang isang taong unvaccinated? Yes or no, and why?
Okay, no problem. As long as sundin yung safety protocols, no? Although I've always been a proponent of vaccination drives, but I do respect, no, yung mga ibang tao na ayaw magpa-vaccine. Hindi ko maintindihan why, pero syempre, galangin natin yon. But I mean, in this campaign, lahat, hindi mo na alam kung vaccinated or unvaccinated. Inakausap mo, pinapasok mo sa sasakyan mo. So I'm fine with that.
freedom of speech and press freedom come with the power to invent fake news. Agree or disagree? Why?
Disagree. Iba yung freedom of the press, iba yung freedom of speech with the power to manufacture fake news. Like, press freedom naman, alam naman natin. No? Ako, journalism graduate rin ako. Eh. Pinag-aralan naman natin na you're there to speak for the truth, or at least you have the certain code para at least yung katotohanan or factual yung iyong reports. So fake news does not have anything to do with freedom of the press. Freedom of speech naman, okay, that's very basic for us, but for as long as you don't also hurt the freedom of one person to also express himself or herself. No? So iba yon, iba talaga yon.
Should social media be regulated or censored? Why?
Dami ng mga batas, no? In fact, I was part of the discussion about that. The danger about pushing legislation covering social media is this could become a tool to stifle freedom of expression. Kasi ang social media naman is really about being able to express yourself. So sa akin, kung magkakaroon man ng regulation, it should be internal. The social media apps themselves should, I don't know how, maybe there's dialogue, pero sila mismo yung mag-re-regulate ng content na pumapasok doon sa kanilang apps. No?
Ika'y pinalad maging senador ng Pilipinas, 19th Congress, your first privileged speech, what is it about and why?
Indigenous peoples, which I will connect to the environment kasi ang mga IPs naman very close to the lupa, no, to the samot-saring buhay. They're guardians of the remaining forests and biodiversity in the Philippines. So I'll talk about who is an indigenous person, ano ba yung kanilang karapatan sa kanilang ancestral domain, and then relate it to protecting the environment.
Teddy, how much are you worth today and why?
Material?
Yes.
Okay, yung last salen ko would be around 3 million. But my ancestral domain is priceless. Maybe materially, kasi wala siyang title, but that's my bundok, this is my rice terraces. Mababa yung material worth niya, but it's priceless for us because yun yung, heritage mo, yun yung mana mo na nanggaling sa mga ninuno mo.
How do you want people to remember you as a senator kung ikay papalarin at bakit?
A senator who is progressive, who is not afraid to push laws that really address the problems of our society. The senator who really fights for the rights of those na kadalasan walang boses sa Senado. I'm not just talking about indigenous peoples, no, but LGBTQ, mag-asaka, mga manggagawa. Because the Senate really right now is the elite, the political elite. So kinakailangan din siguro na high time na meron din boses yung mga kadalasan walang boses doon. And I hope to be able to represent them effectively and ably sa Senado.
Kung ikaw ay may superpowers, anong problema ng bayan ang una mong susolusyonan at bakit?
Again, this is not popular but environment eh. Because sa akin kasi existentialist yung nararanasan na natin ngayon eh. We rarely discuss about climate change but if sabi nila if we don't fight climate change, tuluyang malulubog na ang hindi lang Pilipinas ang buong mundo. So sa akin, and that's not just going to be for the Philippines, but the entire world. Wala na sanang climate change.
Maraming salamat. That ends our 30 political policy questions. Ngayon naman, let's go to our light, a bit naughty, funny question. Teddy, lights on, lights off, and why?
Lights on.
Dahil?
I do more things when lights are on.
Best time for sex, and why?
Oh, after meals, energy.
You are up against 63 other candidates for the Senate. Kung meron kang isasama sa langit, sino ito at bakit?
Ooh, interesting. Harry Roque. Para very exciting naman yung aming buhay sa langit kasi palagi kami mag-discuss at mag-debate doon.
Kung meron ka namang isasama sa impyerno, sino ito at bakit?
Okay, baliktad pala dapat si Harry Roque doon sa impyerno. Si Laila de Lima lang ang isasama ko sa langit.
Okay. Yes or no? Does size matter? And why?
It does in some sense. Though. Sometimes it's good to be small. Sometimes it's good to be big.
Sex or Wi-Fi? At bakit?
At my age, Wi-Fi.
Sex or chocolates? And why?
Ano naman? Sex.
Sex or Senado? And why?
Oh, that's a good question. Bayan muna eh. Bayan muna sa Senado. Sex is for me.
Last question. Daddy, you're at the entrance of heaven. You're at the pearly gates. At naroon ang Panginoon. At sinabi sa'yo, Teddy, anong pinakamagandang bagay na nagawa mo para sa akin? Anong sasabihin mo at bakit?
Yung sa akin, yung pagprotekto ng kanyang linikha, which is the environment. Because actually, when I entered politics, no, ang mindset ko lang was to be able to preserve the Ifugao rice terraces. You know, doon naman kilala ang Ifugao, the rice terraces. But it's crumbling because kinalbo na namin yung bundok, because of climate change. So I told myself, I'll be a warrior for the environment. At sabi ko nga sa sarili ko, sabi ko, Diyos, kung sakaling hanggang mayor lang ako, this governor, importante is na-preserve ko yung Ifugao rice terraces and the surrounding watersheds. And that's still my mindset today. I mean, hindi ko naman alam kung ano mangyayari sa akin these elections or in the coming years, but as long as I did my job of being a warrior for God's creation, which is the environment, that's a good accomplishment for me in my life.
Maraming salamat.
Thank you.
Good luck, mabuhay ka, and pagpalain ka ng Panginoon.
Thank you.
Sponsored by Jonathan So and Karn Makadandang of TokTok and Show My King, Mario Theros of UltraFit Coffee, and Boy So of La Carmela de Boracay.
Hi, people of the Philippines and people of the world. Hit the button below. And you will be subscribing to the Boy Abunda Talk channel on YouTube. Let's keep talking.